What's going on, everybody? It's your boy Chazz, and today we are reviewing Grim Reaper's Rock You to Hell. Welcome back, everybody, to Chazz's Rock Record Review, and today we are reviewing Grim Reaper's Rock You to Hell. Grim Reaper is a British band. I believe in the last episode I said they were a German band. I don't know where I got that from. Sometimes you just make shit up, I guess. I don't know. But it's a band that I know and I like. But this is like the album I was least familiar with. You can see the price. I bought this for $10. I bought this at a record show that was at like a VFW post or something, and it was just a cool find because I'm telling you guys, you don't find a lot of heavy metal vinyl in the wild. You don't. It's hard to find. So finding this one was sweet. So let's take a look-see at what we got here in the album. And it came just like this in this nice little case. Get it out of there for the shininess. Look at that cover, guys. That is so metal. I love it. It's so awesome. It really is. You got the Grim Reaper killing, I don't know, a soldier of some sort. You got the big sickle. You got that sweet 80s font of Grim Reaper up top there. On the back, you got the song names with, like, you know, kind of church-inspired font writing there. This album has 9 songs. Rock You to Hell, Night of the Vampire, Lust for Freedom, When Heaven Comes Down, Suck It and See, Rock Me Till I Die, You'll Wish You Were Never Born, Wasted Love, and I Want More. You can see the guys down here. That looks like a left-handed guitar player right over there. So that's interesting. It's an RCA. 1987, produced, mixed, and engineered by Max Norman. For On Year Bike Limited, let's check out the inserts. Interesting for me that it comes out pink. I don't know if it used to be red. But it's interesting that a metal band like this, you know, like an old school 80s metal band, came out with this pink stuff. Especially 1987, right? It wasn't so... so cool. I like the flaming Grim Reaper down there. Grim Reaper is Steven Grimmett on vocals, Nick Bowcott guitars, Marc Simon on drums, David Chief Wanklin bass. The guitarist and the singer in this band, I'm sorry, the other side is lyrics. The guitarist and the singer in this band are awesome, guys. This is that kind of 80s metal that I love. It is just high register singing, great guitar solos. But look at this album, man. Pristine condition. Pristine. $10 I spent on this a couple of years ago. $10. One thing that you're always going to get at my house, and I don't care because it's my house and my records, is you're going to get cat fur everywhere, and even though I got an expensive stylus needle on the record player, there's always gonna be cat fur on my vinyl, no matter what I do, and I don't care because that's my baby, and it makes me happy that she's here and she sits around and listens to heavy metal music with me. So, what can be better than that? So now that you got to check out all the actual vinyl, this is, like I said, this is the 87 cut. It sounds fantastic. Why don't we get to the music? We'll be right back.
like Grim Reaper? Are you a fan?
That's right, guys. You got to check out those cuts right from my actual vinyl, my setup, my turntable, my Fluence, my Blue Ortofon needle, my Sony speakers, my Kenwood receiver. That's my setup. It's retro speakers, retro receiver, brand new stylus, brand new turntable. You guys collect what you want. Do it how you want it. This is the setup I prefer. Obviously, you don't always get the best sound quality recording a speaker playing, right? Instead of just uploading. But I wanted to give you guys a little more feel, a little more love, and feel what I feel and listen to how I listen to it. It sounds great. The vinyl sounds great. I hope the sound came through for you guys. I'm not sure. Maybe if I can find a music video for this, maybe I'll scoot it up there. I keep getting copyright stuff, of course, but thankfully I've got nothing taken down yet. So we'll have to see. So this album, right there. I also got my little setup here now. So Grim Reaper, Rock You to Hell. Obviously, I have the vinyl. I listen to the vinyl. Sounds great. Not on Spotify. Could not listen to it on Spotify. So the times in my car or at work, I had to listen to it on YouTube. It's all on there, though. Sounds great. Rock You to Hell is the third studio album by British heavy metal band Grim Reaper, released in 1987 under the RCA label. This was the band's final album for 29 years until the release of Walking in the Shadows in 2016 under the name of Steve Grimmett's Grim Reaper, the singer. And their last one to feature guitarist Nick Bowcott, bassist Dave Wanklin, and drummer Marc Simon. Again, this is pretty much the last album. The final album in 2016, or the couple after that, were Steve and Grimmett's solo projects. And I believe Steve Grimmett has passed away. We'll just double check that. Steve Grimmett passed away last year. Oh, just kind of recently, August of 2022. So rest in peace to that guy. He has a fantastic, fantastic voice. Grim Reaper gained brief mainstream critical and commercial success with this album, do the regular airplay of Rock You to Hell on MTV's Headbangers Ball and AOR album-oriented rock radio stations. I was too young, so I don't remember Grim Reaper being on MTV, and I never have ever heard Grim Reaper on local Buffalo, New York radio. So, interesting that that's the way it kind of came up. But we're here to talk about the music. And you heard three songs coming into this, and I will circle them as we come along to them. This album is great, guys. I love this album. I love every song on this album, to be honest. And I told you, I was pretty much, I don't want to say unfamiliar with it. I knew a few of the songs, three or four of them, but out of the nine, I didn't know them all. I love every song on here. I don't think there's a skip on this album. I mean, okay, we'll just get moving. The first track, title track, Rock You to Hell. 4 minutes long, 4 minutes and 1 second. This is the song, I mean, one of the songs I knew going into it. Steve's voice is so high, the way it kicks in, you heard it. He sounds great. Nick's guitar is great. It's kind of a politically driven song, but not in any, like, sides. 1987, I mean, politics was always in music, but, like, it got really cliche over the last decade or so to, like, choose your side politically and put it in your music, where, like, this is just kind of that song that's like, you know what, whomever is in charge is trying to take metal music away from you, and that was true back then because of all that stuff, and that's when you got your Frank Zappas and your John Denvers and your Dee Snyders in court fighting and doing all that stuff. You know, this is right in the thick of it. So it was kind of like anti-early cancel culture against heavy metal. So, like, it's cool to hear that and to see, like, a band trying to fight that. And that's really cool. And I love the song. Track two is Night of the Vampire, another song you heard. What a cool, catchy song, man. Steve's voice is out of control in this song. I'm a singer, if you guys didn't know, and, like, he's a guy I won't touch. Like, it's just, he's so high, I can't get in there and tell you he kept his voice for 30 years down the line and any of that stuff. But on this album, it's so good. I mean, every song's a recommend. Track three, Lust for Freedom. Awesome. awesome, catchy. It's always stuck in my head. Lust for Freedom. Da, 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 da. Great catchy song, man. Great catchy song. Track 4, When Heaven Comes Down. Another catchy song. It's interesting to think of, you know, the band's Grim Reaper. I'm not going to call them a Christian metal band by any means. They have a lot of hell imagery and stuff. I mean, you see it over here. But When Heaven Comes Down, that's more about angering the gods and anger in heaven and stuff like that. Interesting dichotomy in their music, and I love it. Okay, here it is. And you heard a little bit of this. Track 5, the last track on side A, side 1, whatever, however they do it, is Suck It and See. Interesting. This song has a total, like, swag to it. Like, it's just got that strut, that groove, right? And right away, boom, he's talking about a woman asking to take him home. And he's just got the swag, and he's talking about resisting temptations but taking the invitation. Like, I like the lyrics and how the song starts. And then, like, the chorus is she is saying, suck it and see. And I don't know what it means, right? I don't know. And I'm not judging. I don't think we're talking about a woman with a genitalia, a male genitalia, or anything like that. It could be, right? I mean, I think that's what to make you think what I'm thinking. And it's hard to break through on the lyrics. And I don't think it's really about a transgendered woman. I think it's about, like, a vampiric thing. Maybe, like, you know, like, suck the blood and see. I mean, track 2 was Night of the Vampire. They always have this dark imagery. I think they played the word, you know, they did some wordplay game, some innuendo. But I don't know. Maybe it is about, like, a transgendered hookup. Sweet! Back in 87? I mean, that's bold if that's the case. Especially back in 87. Be a little, you know, it would be bold today, but not as bold. So, but I don't think that's what it's about. And if it is, man, hey, good on you, bro. Be brave and talk about it. But I don't think it is. I think it's got some vampiric background. But it's a cool song. It's just different from everything in this album. It's just got this sexy swag and just, like, it's so cool. I love, this is my favorite song, I think, on the album now. Suck It and See. Flip the record, y'all. Boom. Side 6. Rock Me Till I Die. This was meant to be a, like, pump your fist arena rocker song and sing along. And it's great. It's a great song. And I do like the next song a lot. You'll Wish That You Were Never Born. His voice, again, is out of control on this song. Out of control. So high. The registers that I couldn't even imagine. I don't think there's any way this guy was singing like that in the 2016 release. But maybe he was. I didn't get a chance to ever check it out. But maybe he was. Then we only got a couple of songs left. Wasted Love. And I Want More. And they're great songs to end the album with. I think that this album, I severely underrated this album. You severely underrated this album. MTV severely underrated this album. The radio obviously severely underrated this album. I just think the metal community slept on this band. I would think their most famous song is See You in Hell, which is from their release, their debut release, which great song, great album as well. Do I have that one? I'm not sure if I have that album. I have two. They only had the 3 in the 80s. I have 2 of them. Obviously this one and one of the other two. I can't remember which one now. But I think it's the second one. I gotta find See You in Hell. But this album, I'm gonna give this like an 8.5. I don't wanna go as high as 9, but it's definitely one of the better albums completely that we've delved into. From at least from the unknowing one, and this is number 7, right? So, like, at least from the unknowing terms, this is one of the better albums that we got to go over. I really do like it. I really do recommend it. If you guys did your homework on this, I'm thinking you liked it. If you like hard rock and heavy metal music, I mean, it's heavier, a lot heavier than Sammy Hagar. That's for damn sure, right? And there's nothing wrong with that. Sammy Hagar was really good too, but this is, you know, this is me. I love 80s metal. I love emo music. I love Kiss. I love screaming hardcore music. You're going to get a weird selection with me. My record collection is over 500 deep. And this is at random, so we don't know what we're going to get. Here are the rules. Here's our next. Here's your homework, guys. Here's what we're doing. Here's our next album. Remember, here are the rules. I'm going to shake my collection in the Discogs app. We're going to do the random album that pops up. We are going to skip, if it's a Christmas album, gone. We are going to skip if it's an album, obviously, we've already done. Over 500 albums, only 7 deep. We shouldn't pull one that we already did, but if we did, okay. Then we'll deal with it. And then maybe once in a great while, I'll reserve the right to just skip one because I don't want to or I don't think it will make a great review. But I'm normally going to stick with everything. So let's do it. All right, here we are. We're in our collection. We always start right there in the numbered. You got, you know, right up there the numbers and the A's, right? 36 Crazy Fists and 30 Seconds to Mars right on top. So, let's give it a shake and see what happens. We're gonna skip this one. This came up Black Hole of Calcutta. I am going to skip this one for now just because this was just some random vinyl I got in a box. We're just gonna skip that one. It's grindcore. I don't like it, so gone. It's gone. We're not doing it. So let's try this again. Okay, we could do this one. This is a cool one. All right, we've got Dio Magica. And yes, I have that one. I have the, I don't even know if you can see this stuff, but I have the nice and pretty picture disc. This is Dio's, now this one's actually worth some money. $75, $128, up to $316. This is a ladder release from Dio. I was just looking at something. The reason that it's worth so much money is because it was a Record Store Day release. And the picture disc, and I bought it, and I'm a big Dio guy, and I absolutely love this. Okay, I just wanted to pull up the exact date. Okay, yes. Magica is the 8th studio album by Dio. It's a concept album, and it was released on March 21st, 2000. So we're in the new millennium with Dio here. Nearly 20 years into his solo career. More than 20 years into his career. So, yes, I know I skipped the the grindcore record, but it's not for me. Sorry. I just know I won't like it. So it was just a part of a random pack that I bought, and it's gone. Don't like it. It's gone. So that is your homework, guys. Dio Magica. If you want to dunk on me for skipping over the grindcore album, by all means do it, but make sure you do your homework of Dio Magica. But if you didn't do your homework, guys, Grim Reaper, see you Rock You to Hell, See You in Hell's a great one too, but Rock You to Hell is an awesome album and it's highly recommended. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. I hope you check this out. I hope you check out Dio Magica. I hope you guys are enjoying. Please leave me some comments, but please like and subscribe. You guys know the drill if you watch YouTube. That means a lot to a new channel. And our last Sammy Hagar review had the most views ever for one of my videos in a very quick amount of time. So hopefully we can keep that rolling, get some more subscribers. I even had some trolls on there. What's up, trolls? How you doing, buddy? How you doing, troll? And that's great. Maybe you're going to watch this video too and shit on me too. And that's okay. His feedback was, I didn't know Sammy Hagar's bassist and stuff because he used to be in Montrose. He told me to do my homework. And I said, guess what, brah? This is my homework, right? I didn't know much about Sammy Hagar. I didn't ever listen to the album. I'm learning. And, he taught me something. And even though he's a troll dick, I appreciated the information. So thank you for that. Grim Reaper, a band that probably nobody knows about. So hopefully I introduce you to something sweet. If you're a big fan, let me know some stuff. Teach me. Moving on to Dio. I know a fair amount about Dio. I'm not too worried about that. So we'll be all set for next week. But until then, we'll see you next time. Peace.